Following the arrest of a freight forwarder, Otumba Sunday Oyebola, a chieftain of the Association of Nigerian Licensed Customs Agents, ANALCA, by the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, NDLEA, over alleged drug importation, the association is engaging the NDLEA to resolve and bring the importer to book. The acting national president of ANALCA, Dr. Kayode Farrington, while speaking with journalists, says the arrested ANALCA chieftain was a victim who failed to do proper diligence in the contract. According to Farrington, the name on the bill of lading clearly showed the accused agent wasn't the importer of the consignment, but the freight agent failed to utilize the indemnity form to exempt himself from such liability.
Some of the members of the NECON called this press briefing so that we, first of all, correct the erroneous impression going around that ANALCA chieftain is involved in clearance of illicit drugs and psychotropic substance, and also reiterate all our efforts in the last few months to enlighten our member and sensitize them on the role to play, particularly in the course of cargo clearance. To also let you know our efforts that we are collaborating with National Drug Law Enforcement Agency as an association, it is our responsibility. Otumba Sunday Oyebola is a high member of ANALCA, one of the chapter executives in PTML, and he's been involved in clearing of a cargo container said to contain three vehicles. And unfortunately, at the point of examination, loud and some psychotropic substances were found in that container. But let me say this, that Otumba Sunday Oyebola is just a clearing agent. He is not the importer of the consignment, and the consignment was not consigned in his name, has been erroneously published by paid agent of this other group. And this issue now is being politicized. It is a national issue, and we should have concern as regards the safety of our environment.
It is to let the general public know that the man in question is not a drug dealer, has been reported. He's not a drug lord. He's just a freight forwarder who has a job hazard. Okay? And most importantly, as Mr. President has said it, we have been sounding this to the eardrums of our member, that it's most important that we do a KYC of whoever, you know, that has a dealing with us.
Farrington also advised all freight forwarders to at all times give an indemnity form for importers to sign and notarize, as this will be their safe haven.
So we still want to tell them that protect yourself by signing indemnity form. We have designed an indemnity form. You can come to the secretariat and we have put it on our platform. We are not collecting any money from anybody. Just download this, it's just an ordinary form. The moment you put the necessary information needed, the fact of a billeting, and it is notarized, that is when it becomes a legal document. Mm-hmm. Even if your importer signs the indemnity form and it is not notarized, it is not a legal document. Because we want it to be a legal document, that is why we are advising that go a step further and make sure that it is notarized. In the whole of our paper here, you can notarize any document under 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. So we are imploring all freight forwarders, licensed custom agents, to go a step forward. As soon as you are picking bill of lading, allow your importers to sign the indemnity form and make sure it is notarized. The issue of vicarious liability is very, very clear. You cannot go before the law and say, I do not know. There's nothing like that before the law. Once you are licensed as a custom broker, you should know that there are danger inherent in it. But let it be seen that you have protected yourself.
Brownson Uwana, Valenson Maritime.